nervous womb and his wife. Thank you for this great journey and testimony. And thank you, Father, that you have lifted them up as an example for many in many aspects. Today we ask a special blessing on this, your servant, and his wife.
Blessing and a privilege to be able to honor my parents today. There are many things I could say about mom and dad. They are strong disciplinarians and both incredibly driven people and sometimes occasionally quite stubborn. It's true. But being a witness of their lives together has lent me many valuable lessons. They truly are my greatest mentors and the most honest critics in my life. But today, I simply just want to thank them. So, Mom and Dad, Thank you for always leading by example and for showing us what it means to trust God through seasons of joy, seasons of frustration, and even seasons of pain. Thank you for showing us what it looks like to choose purpose. Thank you for your transparency as humans navigating this life, for giving us confidence, and for not letting our disappointments determine our success. Thank you, Mama, for your endurance. We have witnessed you both go through the fire. We have seen you and been with you in the unbearable seasons when the battles felt eternal, but you clung on to God. Thank you for reminding us that God is the only authority who can determine what doors open and close in our lives. You have set a high standard in our lives. I look at you and I know the road has not been easy, but you are still here, always choosing each other, pressing towards the mark. Your joy is contagious. Your generosity is inspiring. You have been given a vision that has and will continue to impact this nation. May we, your children, be as diligent as you and be the vessels that will continue to carry on God's purpose in this earth. We honor your labor. We celebrate your love. And we thank you. Thank you, Mama. Thank you, God.
Chief Tennessee Commission, Mukarambo II of Lusaka Province. And I want to say that I'm so humbled today by the Mumba family for identifying me in Lusaka Province, where there are so many leaders here, political leaders, presidents, and others who should have been the guest of honor at this very important function. I am humbled myself. To the audience, it's just a small token for what the Mwiras have done to the Mumbas. The Mumbas have invited me to be a guest of honor at this function. As a chieftainess, I don't have money. All I can do to give Amayu.
Mukwaila inama shiwinkwete, kuibumba, akuliba mama, shikwete fia kutini ngalani. Pana mumu ene ni mfu nga uka, papu piogubwa achite fikuli. Shachichete kena. Namba bachina lubula lisa chini haba mumu, lona muli vene. Mwana ini fia kupefi, kutiwa ene kera kwena. Awa na ine ndipanshi, ni chama kufia likonta ikanga na awa.
And I just want to thank Doc for being a gentleman. A gentleman, that's what he is. And a loving father, very committed to his children. He's not, I mean, they're not present with us. They've grown, they've left the nest, but sometimes they forget that he's the one who put them to bed when they were younger. You know, when children get older, they start saying, no, dad, you don't spend time with us. You're always doing politics. And I have to say, no, but remember that for about, until you are almost teenagers, it was your father who put you to bed, sang you songs from Chinsali, told you how great Chinsali is, and that it's holy ground, and that it's a city, and things like that. So, very confusing. Especially when you visit Chinsali. So, I love you, Doc. You're a great guy. And let's hope you'll be a greater grandpa. And thank you all for coming. I'm truly, truly humbled. And I want to acknowledge, I've got sisters, I've got cousins, I've got great women whom I left this thing to do, and they did it and outran me.
I would like to acknowledge my brothers and my sisters who are here. Some people have asked me, where do you draw your strength from all the stuff you go through? From God, from my family, and from friends like yourself. Our scripture for our wedding was that a cord of three strands is not easily broken. That's what was on our card. And many times my strand would get tired, her strand would get tired, but God's strand is what we held on to through the storms of life. And if there had been no God, I do not think we could have come this far. In fact, Abasha Ishmael and I are still married in Aliba Chindika. I respect them. They don't know God and they're still married. Because me, I cannot manage. If God was not there, it could have been complicated. So we give honor and praise to God. But the important thing about my relationship with Florence is that I am what I am because of her besides God. And a lot of Zambians don't know that. Sweetheart, I don't know how to say thank you, but I really love you. You've given me five children and six grandchildren. Thank you so much for being such a great woman. Not only that, but for putting this whole show together. And she worked for five months to put this thing together. And she taught me something. I'll ask my assistant to bring my little flower that I wanted to. Thank you so much. I love you. Thank you. Thank you so much, and God bless you. And allow me to thank our great director of program. I have been so honored to have an ambassador of his caliber to be the director of program. For him to say yes, it affirms me that I can run for president this year. I mean, if he knew I should not run for president, I don't think he would have said yes. But he had to consider many things. And once we win, we'll talk again. Thank you so much, Your Excellency. Thank you.